of us. Together.
Cleo, please. It's safe here. You need to think about the...
Stop, okay? We're not staying, so just stop. That's that.
Sounds like she means business.
Yeah, it does.
It might be better.
Come on. We're leaving.
In there, but. Kenny, you're like.
I'm only supposed to give out one per group, but. Look. If you're in the area, check back in a few months. We might be accepting people then.
Thank you for the help. And, sorry for the language.
Well, it's a shitty situation. We're all doing the best we can. You all stay safe out there.
Kenny, I don't know anybody in there. There's a chance it is safer in there. It could break down like the rest of them. They've got guaranteed food, but how am I supposed to just let you walk into the sunset and possibly die?
You're as stubborn as a damn mule.
Yeah? Wonder where I got that from.
Fantastic. Oh, man. Wow. Screw you, Fraps, lagging it. Oh, my God. Oh, man. We would have left Kenny and... Oh, wow. No, it has to be a loyalty thing. That's 13.5% of players are with Kenny. Wow. Wow. 13.5% are with Kenny. Dang. Dang. And we're in the minority for not shooting him either. Okay, yeah, screw Mike and them. Did not try to help Luke. I'm guessing they meant with the Bonnie area. And, of course, we protected the baby. Okay, I'm kind of... Only 84%, huh? All right. Wow. I suppose I'm going to have to do a thoughts video then. All right, it's over. Let's have our thoughts. Well... Wow, where do we start? Let's go ahead and, I guess, start with Kenny versus Jane. Probably some confusion on why I might have sided with Kenny there. Surprisingly, it has nothing to do with the fact that I have been loyal to Kenny throughout the whole series. When I think about what Jane did, she pretended to have a child murdered, knowing very well that the person she was going to piss off with this the most had already lost a wife, a girlfriend, a kid, a best friend, and we can even count the entire season one cast if we so much wish. So Kenny definitely has his demons in his head, and this girl purposely tries to bring the demon out of Kenny in order to prove a point to Clementine. This is a stupid move on the part of Jane. This is a ridiculously stupid move on the part of Jane. I was actually very disappointed with her as a character. The writing itself, phenomenal, 10 out of 10, but... To kind of look at it from Jane's perspective, I really don't understand what she was hoping to accomplish here. I really do have to side with Kenny in that I truly believe Jane was just looking to pick a fight. She immediately drew the knife. She believed that Kenny was going to rush her. So, I don't know, you could argue that's just instinct, though. This guy's crazy, shoving around children and everything. Getting everyone else flipped out. Beating up handcuffed people. Tied up people and... So, of course, she's going to draw the knife when he comes storming down her door, but... Yeah, I don't know, it didn't seem like that was a good idea on Jane's part. If she really wanted Clementine to see Kenny for what he was, this was not the approach to take. I was trying to think for a long time what approach you could possibly take. However, I think it would just ultimately be left up to Clementine as to which side to side with in this case. Kenny, while he is a bit more deranged than we remember him from season one, he has gone through quite a bit. He's even showed anger towards us, as Clementine. I still believe that he is the more sound of the two, and that he was the more sound of the two. That is why I ultimately made the decision to let him go ahead and kill Jane. If I had to pick between the two of them, it was definitely Kenny. He does have the interests of the group in mind, even if he doesn't really seem like it. I attribute this more to him actually having the people that he knows more closely in his mind, as opposed to everybody. So maybe that was a bad choice of words, that he has the group in his head, but it's really only Clementine, AJ, and whatever other major ally they might have at the time. He definitely has become less trusting of people as time passes. He was questioning pretty much everyone's motives throughout the entire season. He remained to himself quite a bit, although we can see why Sarita just died and everything. So I don't know. Tough call with Kenny, but I really did have to side with him here. You can't insult the man's family, run off with an infant, come back empty-handed, with the intent to piss off the guy that you've hated since, like, the beginning, and expect anything different than what happened. So, as good of a character as Jane was, she probably got what she deserved here. She ditched the group before, she did come back, so clearly she had a lot of trust for Clementine and vice versa. It was a shame that she had to suddenly... I don't know what possibly could have gone off in her head to make her want to do this as a character, you know, because I have to pretend this is all in-universe and everything. But yeah, so I don't know, that one's just kind of a shame to me that Jane had to be the one to pull the trigger in the wrong way. But yeah, okay, so I guess that's my rant / explanation on Kenny versus Jane. It was a very interesting event as far as the writing goes. I would have not expected that after what Bonnie and Mike, what was the other guy's name, Arvo, did to us at the end there, that our final two partners would have been fighting it out not even 10 minutes later. A little more time in universe, but still, episode-wise, this fight came relatively quickly, and it was kind of a shame. But anyway, I don't know, I guess, I wonder if that was the point of the season, actually. So, like, season one was kind of all about fighting against the walkers and trying to figure out what they were all about. You can argue there were mishaps here and there, like, I can't remember the name of Lily's father, but that crazy guy. So there was definitely infighting with the groups. There always was. But definitely season two seemed to feature the infighting among the group a lot more, especially when you had things like Carver and Bonnie trying to repent for what she did and then suddenly turning on Clementine again if you allow Luke to die. So there was a whole lot of infighting. It was very interesting. And then I guess what happens here is when there's nobody left to fight, you're kind of forced to fight yourself, and I guess that's what Kenny and Jane were both doing, is they were both fighting themselves through this whole season. Kenny had to fight himself and, like, restrain his actions for the sake of Clementine and this baby on the way. He had to stay sane, he had to help the group, so he had to fight past his own demons, and Jane had to eventually convince herself to return to the group for the good of Clementine and maybe herself. So maybe she was in it for herself as well. So, I don't know, it's kind of neat. When you run out of people to fight, you only have the gun to turn on yourself, it seems. So I love this season. There was just a lot going on in this season. And now the final decision. Why did I go with Kenny? Yeah, this one was actually a little more difficult, where I cut out at the end of last episode. I actually spent quite a bit of time thinking as to which of these two scenarios I should have gone for. And I was really, really close to leaning towards Wellington. I'm not gonna lie. I really was close to leaning toward Wellington. The reason I ultimately sided with Kenny. This man is dangerous. This man said himself that he does not trust himself to protect Clementine and AJ as time moves on. But I really don't see it that way. There seems to be this, like, unspoken bond between Clementine, our Clementine in particular. If you raised a different Clementine, this would obviously be thrown out. But for my Clementine, there is this unspoken bond between her, Lee, and Kenny. That's how it has always been. That's not the only reason I chose Kenny. The thing about Wellington to me was we could go into Wellington and potentially be safer. We would not know anybody in Wellington and have to live with the fact that we abandoned absolutely everybody. Nobody was in Wellington. Krista was not in Wellington. Kenny was going to be left to fend off on his own. We had to let Jane die. We had to abandon Bonnie, Mike, and Arvo. We had to kill off a whole bunch of other people. So we're finally in Wellington, but it is such a bittersweet victory that I'm not sure how our Clementine would have been able to live with herself. On the other hand, if she goes with Kenny, she does run the risk of dying, and she even puts this child's health and life in danger. AJ is definitely in a lot more danger going with Kenny. I do believe this. I'm not completely ignoring that at all. But Clementine at least feels safe knowing that she is with someone she knows. She's with someone that she has a lot of experience with. She has been able to talk Kenny down in the past, and she doesn't have to feel like she abandoned him just to, like, have the good life in this Wellington place. The other fact to point out is that the person, I can't remember her name, at the gate to Wellington, even said, hey, maybe come back in a couple months and maybe there will be an opening. I'm almost certain that won't be the case. Maybe Kenny and Clementine will wander far, far away from Wellington, because I doubt they're just coming back to this little station here. They're not going to want anything to do with it. And I think the game said it took them like 9 days to get there, so it wouldn't be very productive anyway. They're going to have to find something else to do. The supply issue. It was 9 days. 9 days it took them to get from this rest house or whatever to Wellington. And now they have 2 bags worth of stuff. We don't know what the stuff is, but clearly these people have been able to survive on next to nothing, including AJ. So I don't even think the supplies come into much effect here. They have plenty of supplies for the three of them, especially since the person was nice and gave us double, so I don't think that'll be a problem. I really don't think it'll be a problem, so I feel as though Clementine can rest a little easier knowing that she didn't have to do this twice, where she has to basically abandon her best companion at the end of both seasons. She had to kill Lee at the end of season one. That's what we had her do at the end of season one. She put the bullet in Lee's head. To abandon Kenny in season two would possibly bring back a whole bunch of repressed memories about this, and feel like no matter what she tries to do or what she tries to accomplish, her group is going to fall apart. At least this way, she is able to, like, convince herself that the group doesn't always have to die. She can maybe prove Jane wrong, that the group doesn't always have to die. Everything fell apart at this final episode, except for Kenny. So she at least has Kenny. I guess that's kind of my viewpoint on this, as to why I would have her run off with Kenny, for the familiarity, the internal feeling of safety. Although one thing that I thought was kind of funny is how they actually had us drop the gun right outside the gate. So I honestly didn't think of this until like just now, but I hope they picked the gun back up when they walked away from Wellington. It would be very silly if they just left this weapon lying on the ground and did nothing with it. I don't know. I know they wanted us to have the cozy go-home moment with Kenny and Clementine and AJ walking off into the horizon for their next adventure or hardship or whatever. But still, it's like, why wouldn't you go back to pick up the gun if you're being turned away from this place that didn't want you to have it? It's not like the person would have shot her or anything. She was still going to feel sorry for them and just probably let them go. So I don't know. I thought that was a bit funny. So hopefully they picked up the gun. Oh, my major disappointment with this whole thing, though, is that we're probably done with these characters. I would love to not be done with these characters, because I think it would be amazing to truly have all the possible paths. Like, are you with Jane and AJ? Are you just with AJ in Wellington? Are you just with AJ? Did you kill Kenny? Did you kill Jane? Who are you with at the end? Are you in Wellington? I think this could be a blast if they actually started off season three with answering the question as to where you personally are. And even if they do, I wouldn't be at all surprised if they just happened to say, look, you came back to Wellington and now you're in Wellington again. Hooray for you. You either have an extra companion or you don't. Now, that would be a little silly and kind of a cop-out if they did that, but it would be a little better than nothing. My prediction for season three is it's a little hard to actually predict, so maybe predict's not the right word here. What I would like for season three is if we're truly done with Clementine and Kenny, or whatever choice we made, I would not mind playing as AJ, especially if we're playing as AJ grown up. So, if I'm honest here, I think Clementine has run her course as a child. If we see Clementine again, I am not all that confident that she would be a kid again. I could see them doing a time skip. I would not want them to, because I write things too. I want all the details filled in the middle, but I could definitely understand if they wanted to do a time skip with this and have us play as AJ instead. I somehow doubt we'll be playing as Clementine again. Unless they, I don't know, got overwhelming response for the fans or already had the story in the works or something. Chances are we're probably changing characters every season. So if we do play as AJ and do a time skip, what would be pretty interesting is if they had some flashbacks that have to do with Clementine's final decision here. Like, so our Clementine is going with Kenny off into the horizon. So if we're playing as adult or kid AJ, why don't we have some flashbacks of maybe what Clementine and Kenny did when they ran off into the sunset? Maybe some hardships they had to endure, or maybe some campy moments or something. Some good memories to build for this new character, if we're going to play as AJ. If we're not playing as AJ, it's all up in the air for me. I have no idea what to expect. We might have brand new characters. It would suck if we do, because I like the episodic feel to the seasons. This season was a direct sequel to Season 1, and I would love for Season 3 to be a direct sequel to Season 2, because I am not done with these characters by a long shot. These are phenomenal characters. I do not understand the people who go the way of saying that it's bad acting or whatever. I think this is phenomenal writing. I enjoy the characters' voices. I enjoy their motivations. I enjoy getting to know them. That is a huge strength of this series, if not the strength. So I'm really looking forward to Season 3. If we get AJ, I hope we get some good flashbacks. That's all I'll say about that. So yes, that was Walking Dead Season 2. I can't remember what my rating is from Season 1. I'm going to match it here. This did a phenomenal job following up to Season 1. I would not change anything about how this was played. Some of the quick time events and things were a little goofy. Seemed like the timing was a little off or something, but you can get past it because the storytelling is just so good. It really makes this worthwhile. You really are just playing a movie. You're playing a movie and occasionally walking one of the characters around and changing the dialogue. That's literally all you're doing, because they have a story they want to tell and they're going to let you tell it. But at the same time, you do have some control. You had a lot more control in this season, I thought, than the last season. You basically had two endings in the last season. You shoot Lee, or you leave Lee to die himself and reanimate, which is not even that different. Here we got drastically different endings, and I truly hope they play off of the drastic outcomes that you can have at the end here. Oh, man. I can't remember my other thoughts, so you should bear with me here. But yeah, so I'm definitely matching the Season 1 rating. Ah, the game... Okay, so, like, they did try to add a couple new mechanics to the gameplay, like the little thing with the mouse where you had to click it and hold it and move in a direction, or some of the escape sequences where you had to move a certain direction, or the action sequences rather, where you had to move a certain direction at certain points. So they added a couple new mechanics, but they did not change the core gameplay, because they don't need to change the core gameplay. There are some series out there that produce sequel after sequel with the exact same gameplay, and they become less popular over time. I would hope that does not happen to Walking Dead, because The Walking Dead's core mechanic is its storyline. Maybe not even mechanic, it's the core feel of the game is its storyline. So I seriously think that as long as they keep writing the way they are, if they keep us so engaged in these characters that I want to just waste a whole episode talking about fathoming what could possibly happen in Season 3, then I think they're doing a phenomenal job. So, seriously, if you have not picked up Walking Dead, either Season 2 or Season 1, go ahead and do so. It's not that expensive. You get great storytelling. It's worth your time. And I hope you get invested in the characters as much as I have, because this is just a lot of fun. It's strange to think that I'm having so much fun playing a game that is essentially a movie. That's how I view this here. I'm just having fun playing a game that is essentially a movie. So that's it for The Walking Dead Season 2, everyone. I hope you had fun. I know I did too. Sorry for leaving you hanging with some of the cliffhangers, but again, I write as well, so I like to spin a good web and try to, insert my own point of views with things, so I had to give you some cliffhangers at the end of the episodes here. But yes, I'll see you next time for more Teamudf Gaming. Of course, I will keep an eye out for Walking Dead Season 3. It's a shame we might have to wait so long for it, but I can't complain because, you know, we got a couple of these episodes relatively fast, one after the other. I feel like this series was a little shorter than Season 1. It could be because I kept playing the episodes in, like, one sitting or whatever, but ultimately, I don't think it negatively affected the story at all. The writing was just as good compacted, even if it was, so there you go. Alright, I'm done rambling. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope to see you next time for more Teamudf Gaming. Boy!